What is up, everyone? I am Demon Cringe, and ladies and gentlemen, today we got another art review. Oh yes, everyone. Oh yes. So, just like usual, I got three really awesome artists lined up for you today, guys and gals. So yeah, be sure to sit back, relax, and enjoy. So let's start it off with our very first artist for today, called Rin Lee 1221, a varied hobbyist, Sierra female from the United States, and she's been on DA for 1 year. And the first picture we're going to be taking a look at from her is Tara Lee. And as you can see, she is off to a very good track. Like over here, it says it's made with the DeviantArt Miro. And it actually looks pretty decent, you know, for a mural drawing, I gotta say. I really, really do like the hair and the eye, you know. They're very nice and detailed and all that. Yeah, the line work is a little bit choppy, but of course, you know, it's DA Miro, so what are you gonna expect, to be totally honest? Although, I will say a couple things. First off, the eye is a little bit too big. You know, it's it looks like it's encompassing like a third of the face. And the second thing is the ear is placed wrong. Like, it's not supposed to go in the jawbone, it's supposed to be over here. But if you were going for that as like a stylistic choice, then I guess a thumbs up for that. Overall, the picture does look pretty nice, you know, good coloring and all that, nothing clashes, the background is nice and simplistic. And of course, the shading gives a bit of dimension to the hair. But yeah, definitely try to reduce the size of your eyes a little and place the ear on the side of the head. So yeah, Tara Lee, made with DeviantArt Miro. And the second picture we're going to take a look at from her is Cole Crying. Yes, and as you can see, this one is much, much better. This is a traditional style picture. And it is really beautiful, I gotta say. I really do love the coloring in this one. And of course, the style in which this is colored is actually pretty cool. It kind of looks like you were going for like a soft pressure coloring and all that. And it actually does look pretty nice, you know. I also like how the blue kind of sort of gets into the tear a little bit to give it a bit of a fade, which is really nice. And as you can see over here, the coloring from lighter to darker really does contrast well with the lighting and all that. It makes it look a lot more natural, so it actually fits together really perfectly, I gotta say. The line work is very, very nice and smooth, you know, it's a little bit bolded and all that. I really do like that. There is a little bit of a thicker, you know, thicker line over here on the hair, you know, overall it actually looks pretty nice. Yeah, really good job on this one. You've definitely improved. I don't know anymore. Cole Crying. There are just those days when life is so overwhelming that it can bring even the happiest people to tears. That is very, very true. And the second artist we're gonna check out today is Humorous Ivy. Just feeling artsy, a digital art hobbyist. Humorous Ivy, female from unknown. And she has been on DA for only 3 months, and the picture we're gonna take a look at from her is Fall Shelby. And I gotta say, the picture looks really, really nice, you know, very soft, you know, soft mellow colors and all that. It really puts you into the fall mood, I gotta say. There are some, there are a little bit of spots here and there that can use some improvement. Over here, and of course over here we got some choppiness on the line work. It is pretty small, so I can't really see if that's like a... like an error in the drawing itself, or like the compression when you were uploading the picture, you know, maybe it's on like a lower resolution and all that. If that's the case, then definitely try to upload it in a much higher resolution. Now, the line work in general is actually pretty nice and clean. As you can see, it's very defined and all that. Detail work in the clothes, it's really, really nice, as well as over here on the face, you can see. Very nice. On the pupil, we got a little of a pie eye thing going on. The coloring, like I said, is very soft and mellow. It really does go well together, you know, blends super well. And of course, the really nice second outline to give the, you know, character and the objects, you know, a little bit more definition to make everything pop out more. Pretty cool, you know, thumbs up. Basically, my biggest piece of advice for this is, you know, try to upload in a bigger resolution. And of course, you know, if choppiness like this does happen, be sure to iron that out before the, you know, before the, you know, final upload and all that. Fall Shelby, Shelby's latest fall style. Shelby is one of my original characters, originally a Cuphead OC that became his own character. He asks his toon self if anyone is interested. And the third and final artist we're gonna check out today is Kay and the Cypher. Miracles welcome a varied student, Kay and the Cypher, male from the United States. He has been on DA for 8 whole years. And the first picture we're gonna take a look at from him is the best Pyrope. I guess it's supposed to be like a new species and all that. Yeah, fan created species. Another traditional style picture, which is actually pretty, pretty cool. And of course, it is uploaded in a smaller resolution. Again, the first piece of advice I can say is definitely, find a way to upload your pictures in a higher resolution and all that, so everything is much more visible. The picture itself looks really, really nice. First off, I gotta say, the line work is really, really nice and defined, as you can see. The anatomy is pretty cool, as well as the, the detail work. But I do gotta say that this ear right here looks really good. Again, I know that it's, since it's a small picture and all that, a smaller resolution, it's kind of hard to see, but the details are actually really nice. The line work is nice and crisp. But over here on this ear, it kind of looks like it's like a smushed and all. Yeah, it looks like it's a smushed and twisted into a different shape and all. So try to make this ear look more like this one. Besides that, everything else looks really nice. I definitely do love the, line work and all. It's really nice and concise. And the anatomy of the character is basically as it should be. The best Pyrope, what the hell is this AU called? They are so cute. And the second picture we're going to take a look at from him is this one right here. Again, another small upload, but hopefully the artist will try to upload them in a higher resolution. This one is actually done in a much more different style. This is more comic book than anything. And like with the previous one, I gotta say, the anatomy is actually pretty nice in this one, really good. Definitely like the how the arm and the hand are looking over here. We got these really nice crisscrossing lines everywhere to give the character a bit of a more comic book type of feel. The horns look really nice, I gotta say. And of course, the line work in general is actually pretty nice and concise. There's not really all that much I can say to improve upon it, other than, my initial, try to upload it in a higher resolution and all that. Like, if it was, I would have been able to, point out, more details that could, maybe use some improvement that I'm not noticing right now, because these lines are actually making it a little bit harder to notice. But, yeah, overall, it looks pretty nice. I really don't know what else I can say. I can't really notice anything wrong with it, primarily because it's such a small upload. But, yeah, also, I gotta say, good job on this this little thing right here. Really nice small details, as you can see. Very carefully made. So, yeah, keep doing what you're doing, and, of course, upload your pictures any higher resolution. Fantroll Inktober Day 14, using Strife Specibus. I don't know if that's how you pronounce it. His Strife Specibus, is a paintbrush kind, has alchemized a paintbrush with needle bristle. It's useful yet prone to accident weapon. He tends to use it by painting by accident, which scratches his canvas and dulls his needles. Well, that's a pretty interesting description. I didn't actually notice that that was a paintbrush right here. Again, the, crisscrossing lines and details kind of make it hard to notice, especially since in a small resolution. But yeah, everything actually looks really, really nice in this, so keep doing what you're doing and a thumbs up. Well, everyone, that is about it. Yeah, we had some pretty awesome artists today. Again, to those two artists, I know I said this a million times, but be sure to upload your pictures in a much higher resolution. And of course, best of luck to all of the artists featured in this video. I hope that you all get a so much better time, be sure to practice whenever you can. And yeah, thank you all so much for watching. Be sure to subscribe for the bell icon, and if you wish to support me in a point of pitch, link is in the description below. And as always, I'm Demon Cringe. I'll see you guys and gals in the next video.